In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Spirit of God, come and empower us. Fill us with your grace and awareness so that we may realize how much we are blessed beyond our measures, so that we may live a grateful heart, utilizing all the blessings the Lord has showered upon us for his greater glory and for the welfare of the others. We make this prayer in the holy name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. My dear friends, we are in the 33rd Sunday of the Ordinary Time. Next Sunday is the Feast of Christ, the Universal King, and with that we end this liturgical year and we begin the new season of Advent in the new liturgical year. Therefore, the Liturgy of the Word of God this Sunday and the coming Sunday reminds us that we need to live our lives with responsible freedom, because God has blessed us with gifts and blessings so that we need to multiply his goodness and kindness in this world so that the world may become a better place for everyone to live. In today's first reading, the qualities of a God-fearing wife has been described. That is, only those who have the fear of God can build the families. Therefore, it is said a God-fearing mother is equal to 100 priests. The faith that we have received from the lap of our mothers. Therefore, it is the mother who makes the home and the family. Therefore, if the mother is full of virtue and wisdom and fear of God, automatically the children also will inherit the same qualities and virtues and faith. In the second reading today, St. Paul tells us about the second coming of Christ. The gospel we hear about the parable of the talents. To each one of us, God has bestowed as unique capabilities and potential. Not all of us can get 100% of result, but we each one of us can get better and the best results. Therefore, the Lord doesn't expect 100% efficiency, but he expects that we are faithful in the duties that the Lord has, responsibilities the Lord has entrusted to us. That even in our failure, in our success, we need to be faithful to God. So for some of us, the Lord has given us multiple blessings and talents, and we need to multiply it for his greater glory. Therefore, to none of us, the Lord has not given anything. We cannot say that the Lord has not blessed me with anything. Our very health and strength is God's abundant blessing to us. Therefore, we need to count our blessings and magnify it so that for the glory of the Lord, that is the call of every Christian, to be the light of the earth and the salt of the world. Therefore, we need each one of us need to multiply goodness and kindness around us so that this world can become a better place for everyone to live. In the recently concluded election of United States, we are aware how Joe Biden are raised to power. But we know, if we know his personal life, as he was first time elected as a senator, his wife and two children met with a terrible accident and his wife died. And he went through excruciating pain, so much so that he wanted to end his life. But for the sake of his two children, he took the oath as the senator in the hospital itself, and there he nursed them back. And he was a loving parent for the both of the children. And recently, when he was the vice president, he lost his son of the brain tumor. Yet he continued to be hopeful. Had he ended his life that day, today America would not have seen such a selfless and God-fearing Catholic president. Therefore, the Lord is guiding us and leading us in various ways and means, with unseen hands protecting us, leading us, with his empowering and encouraging word of God and his sacraments. Therefore, in each of these we need to be empowered, because the forces of darkness, the laziness, to procrastinate, to postpone things and to remain in our comfort zone, not to take risk, not to become good, but we tend to become worse and bad. Compared to last year, this year we should have been good and extended our good and charitable works. But sometimes if you do not take measures to be good, automatically we grow worse. As St. Augustine writes, what you are is God's gift to you, what you become is your gift to God. Therefore, every day, constantly and consciously, we need to make choices for goodness and kindness so that we may grow in the stature and nature of God, of being benevolent, good and kind. And that is what the Lord expects of us. He does not want us to be lazy and waste our time and resources. But the Lord wants us to be that we need to reap goodness and kindness through our actions, words and deeds in this world. And that is the purpose of every Christian, to be present in this world as to be another Christ, to be the salt and light of the world. Let us therefore pray to Jesus that he may grant us that awareness, that through our words, thoughts and deeds we may bring forth goodness and kindness through our actions, so that in everything we do, the name of the mighty name of Jesus may be glorified and magnified. Toward this grace, let us pray. God's love is so wonderful. Jesus is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful, so wonderful for you and for me. God is always kind when you're lonely. Keep him closer to your heart. He will give you peace. He will give you rest if you have his love in your heart. God's love is so wonderful. Jesus is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful for you and for me. Put your trust in God, everybody, every day and every hour. He will give you joy, he will give you hope, if you have his love in your heart. God's love is so wonderful. Jesus is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful for you and for me. Jesus, we thank you for the innumerable and invisible blessing that you have showered upon with. Help us, Lord, to realize that we are blessed beyond measures, that we may selflessly be givers of, spreaders of joy and love and happiness around us. We make this prayer in your holy name, dear Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.